Before reading whole this book, I just went on with the prizes of prizes for business at 2020. I think a lot of big shots like Mr. Arvind N. Agarwal, who apprised you, and Mr. Hari Bhaskaran from Executive Coach, I think. So, and Mr. V. R. Janardhanan, Sundaram
Brake Linings.
And I found Mr. Srinivasan, J.S., mentor of TTK Group, Mr. Radhakrishnan, who was general manager of HPCL.
No, I owe it a lot to them. As a matter of fact, V.R. Janardhanan, of course, was in fact the main force behind me bringing this book. So he was very exacting in terms of the technicalities. But J.S. Srinivasan, some other the romantic side of the book appealed to him, and he felt it should end on a subham. You know, actually, the hero and the heroine should get married. Get them married. Why are you taking so long? You know. So therefore, that was the kind of thing. And of course, you know, Radhakrishnan, who is with Hindustan Petroleum, he was absolutely fascinated with the blend of you know, the concept, management concepts into day-to-day work. And he appreciated it. Hari Bhaskaran, of course, is a very prolific writer. And he came back saying, look, there are a couple of spaces where it actually needs to be tightening up a little bit. The villains are not villainous enough.
Okay.
So therefore, those things had to be done. So I owe a lot to the people who actually reviewed this.
And also Mr. S. Gurumurthy, corporate advisor and political and economic analyst. I think he also given... I just wanted to know from your side.
No. In fact, Mr. Gurumurthy, in fact, gave it a completely different dimension. In fact, he, in fact, was the one who, in a way, legitimized this book for me.
Okay.
He said, you've caught on to the real.
Okay.
But do you know there are 14 or 15 myths that people carry about small and medium enterprise, which are absolute fallacy? For example, people believe that the small and medium enterprise don't contribute much to the GDP, whereas they do over 50%. He also mentioned that people think that the small and medium enterprises are weakly managed. No, in fact, many of them suffer the pressures of weaker management from bigger companies that they are suppliers to.
Okay.
They're victimized by them, many of them. And of course, most importantly, banks don't want to touch them. So these guys are absolutely self-funded and they are doing yeoman service in terms of providing. You know that small and medium enterprises provide 9 times the employment that big companies do. So if you really ask me, I think they are unsung heroes, and I only wish we respect them the way we respect our teachers, we respect our soldiers, we respect our farmers. I believe the small and medium enterprises people deserve the respect they've denied for far too long.